Hello, Namaskara. Welcome to the e-section of Visveshwara Technological University. I am Professor Hampi Ole, KLS Gautam Institute of Technology, Belagavi, Head of Department of Mathematics. I am dealing with first semester engineering mathematics, 18 MAT 11, that is Module 3 Integral Calculus. This is our fourth lecture. In first lecture, we saw how to define double and triple integrations with some examples, second and third variety of examples. We need to do many other examples. So in lecture number 4 of this 18 MAT 11 integration chapter, I am naming it as integration chapter. So it is integral calculus, double and triple integration. So I am going to have next example, variety of examples. We have to go on doing, get used to this methodology of doing variety of examples. Suppose I am asked to evaluate integration 0 to 1, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. With respect to z, y, x, you can write something here, x plus y plus z, x, y, z, x square, y square, z square, sin x plus cos y plus tan z, something here. But suppose if it is given x, y, z, next is an important step, assigning which is limit of x, which is limit of y, which we call it assigning limits is an important step, making star mark here. So that first of all, let me write as it is, I equal to 0 to 1. In your notes also, there should be separate two steps, because while reading back, don't write this as a first step. You will not understand which you assigned which limits after reading or second time reading. First step as it is as a question. Second step, you write how to assign the limits. We are going to learn now how to assign this. Not difficult, not so difficult. X, y, z. Now let us see which is the first limit to assign. So first limit, suppose you have to see here what is not there. Out of x, y, z, here z is not there. So mark that z, assign the limit. So z equal to 0 to z equal to square root becomes the first limit. Then again come back to second limit. Again see that which is not there out of this. So already z is gone out of xy, which is not there, y is not there here, y is not there. So whatever is not there out of xy, that is this limit y. If it is x, it cannot be limit of x, it has to be limit of something else. Already z is over, so this becomes limit of y. Naturally only x is remaining, and that should be constant limit. So many times we are told last should be constant limit. Hence, last one is x equal to 0 to 1 constant limit. Constant limit goes to x now. So naturally, we have to integrate with respect to z. In this order only we have to integrate. Whenever there is a variable limits are there, they are to be integrated in the order of whatever we have assigned once. So z is the first one. So I will write integrate with respect to z, keeping x and y as constants. So now when I integrate that, I equal to x and y don't touch as it is, time being they don't act, square root of 1 minus x square as it is, dy dx as it is don't touch, xy as it is. Only z part has to be integrated. So only z part, when you integrate, that is this part, dz part, z dz is z square by 2. In the given limits, it is z equal to 0 to z equal to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. So first, finish the complete work of z. Till that, don't go to integrate anything. Finish the complete work of z. Don't go to integrate or simplify anything else. So first, let us put the limits for z as it is. So we are not going to touch the x, y part once again. We are not going to touch I equal to, therefore, looks like this, x equal to 0 to 1 as it is, y equal to 0 to square root of 1 minus x square as it is, xy as it is, and dy dx as it is. Let us finish off the work of z. Which is upper limit minus lower limit work, which is divided by 2 as it is. Wherever z is there, you are substituting, just lifting it and keeping inside here, square root sign. So upper limit is square root of whatever it is, 1 minus x square minus y square. But this whole square is there. Minus of the lower limit wherever z is 0. So whenever you take square root and square will go. Hence, still simplification is there. You are observing that z will not remain after putting the limits. Once you integrate with respect to z, put the limits, z will not remain. So therefore again, x as it is, y as it is, xy as it is, 1 by 2 I will take outside, square and square root are going, 1 minus x square minus y square, that much is remaining, 0 just neglect dy dx. Next term is with respect to y, so I will not touch x part, so this x part take inside. So why not, with careful observation, you should write, make it ready for integrate with respect to y by writing, just see the careful observation to make it a friendly with integration with respect to y. Now you can see that x part and this x part are constants. So I'll bring this x here and integrate. So how I write it, if you are right, I'll be very happy in your mind. See, I'll be writing like this. X into 1 minus x square into y. Again, x into this minus, this is over, this minus sign is remaining. X into y square. Why I wrote little bigger font? Because they are integrating terms. Let me put a common square bracket. So now I will write integrate with respect to y, keeping x as constant time being. So how it looks like now? Half x as it is, and later on dx as it is, integrating with respect to y means only y dy becomes y square by 2, keeping x 1 minus x square as it is. So x into 1 minus x square means I will be multiplying inside. This y dy has become, this marked one has become y dy has become y square by 2 minus this x as it is, 2 has become y raised to 3 by 3. So upper limit minus lower limit, which is y equal to 0 to square root of 1 minus x square dx as it is. Now let us finish off upper limit minus lower limit. What is that? Half. Throughout, whenever one of the limits is 0, throughout you can put upper limit, because minus 0 you can write for lower limit. So this half I am not taking outside. X minus x cube as divided by 2 as it is, upper limit square of this, square root of 1 minus x square whole square. Wherever y is there, I am putting square root of 1 minus x square, square root of n minus x square, minus x into, wherever y is there, square root of 1 minus x square. So that is y cube. So here y into y square, this should be y cube. This y cube integration is y raised to 4 by 4 thank you, minus x into this raised to 4, square root of 1 minus x square raised to 4, this 4 as it is, upper limit is over, so dx as it is, x equal to 0 to 1 as it is, minus 0 lower limit. So, half before integrating, some more simplification. X minus x cube, square root will go x into 1 minus x square whole square divided by 4, here divided by 2. With small observation, if you take x outside again, if you have kept like this only, both of these are same. If I simplify that in this fashion, x into 1 minus x square, again 1 minus x square by 2, minus x into 1 minus x square whole square by 4. So, these two are same here, whole square. So, half minus 4, 1 by 4 is 1 by 4. I can keep it as 1 by 8 times 0 to 1 . So, small simplification will give you what is integrable part. Till that, 1 minus x square . So, I equal to is looking like this now, 1 by 8 as it is, 0 to 1, x into, if you expand it, 1 minus 2x square plus x raised to 4, that's all. And you have to multiply x inside, 1 by 8, 0 to 1, x minus 2x cube plus x raised to 4. And this can be integrated very, very easily. This can be integrated very, very easily. Can you tell me the final answer? Yes, you are right. Somebody told me by ringing, messaging me, this is a, if you are not possible live now. This is my phone number anyway. Anybody wants 1 by 8, x comes x square by 2 minus 2 times x raised to 4 by 4 plus x raised to 6 by 6, x equal to 0 to 1, upper limit wherever x is there, 1, 1, 1 minus whole limit is 0. So that you can write 1 by 8, 1 by 2 minus 2 by 4 plus 1 by 6, upper limit over minus 0, lower limit. You can very easily see that these two are getting cancelled, 1 by 6 into 1 by 8 is final answer. Therefore, final answer I equal to, you can very easily see that 8 into 6. 1 by 48. So, like this variety of examples on doing it. So, you get an idea of how to deal with different types of examples. So, here we go with similar limits, but integrand I will change. Very, very similar limits, I will change the integrand. Next example, evaluate, okay, no problem, evaluate. Suppose the same limits I have kept. I equal to 0 to 1, 0 to square root of 1 minus and 0 square root of 1 minus x square minus y square, sum dz dy dx, but last time integrand was dx xyz, here the integrand is now 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square minus y square minus z square. Important. For your information, just I am here, this is not necessary, but suppose I take a sphere with center 0, 0 and radius 1 and 1/8 part of it. And if you complete that, it looks like this. If you complete that, it looks like this lower part. I am taking only the 1/8 part of it. 1/8 part means this part, this part. Now what happens is, when I take a small unit cube volume, carefully if you observe, this becomes an elementary volume. Instead of elementary area in two dimension, you take dx, dy, no? Here you have to take elementary volume dx, dy, dz. Then first, suppose integrating with respect to z. Then parallel to z axis, you move this like this, so that you will be creating a column like this, column, a column, and upper part will be a spherical part. Lower part will be this plane. So this is height z equal to 0 to this height, which is z equal to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. If you square and add, you will get x square plus y square plus z square equal to 1. This is the sphere. That means z equal to 0 means xy plane to this sphere, first z limits are there. Now you vary that parallel to y axis. Like this, you vary this whole column parallel to y axis. So you will be generating a wall-like structure like this, which is generated because of this column, which is already created, So this wall-like structure is here. Till this, this is from this plane, xz plane, y equal to 0 to this line, to this curve. This is z equal to 0. If you substitute here, this becomes x square plus y square equal to 1 circle, and y equal to square root of 1 minus x square. So this line is, actually y equal to 0 line from this point to this. So x axis to circle, it is moving. X axis is y equal to 0 and circle is y equal to square root of 1 minus x square. This whole wall, you have to move from minimum of x to maximum of x, because radius is 1, x equal to 0 to 1. Just for understanding, I told, we will be coming back to such things in the evaluation of volumes. And if at all I keep 1, suppose my integrand is 1 and integrate exactly the volume of the sphere, 1/8 the volume of the sphere, 4 by 3 or 4 pi r by 3 r cube, where r is 1, 4 by 3 pi r cube, if r is 1, 4 by 3 pi, into 1/8 part of that you will get. Now, assigning the limits, 0 to 1, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square, 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square minus y square minus z square. Purposely I am marking this for my integration purpose. Naturally, like last example, this becomes integration limit for z, because z is not there here. So dz first. Next one is, already z is over, means this becomes limit of naturally y, because already z is over. So y equal to this to y equal to this, natural remains is x. So now then, this is second one is y, third one is x. So now first one is integrate with respect to z, keeping x and y constants. So how it looks like? I equal to. X as it is, Y as it is. Before integrating, I keep this 1 upon square root of this constant, I keep it as something square. This constant, I can keep it as something square, some constant square, minus z square. So this part is k square, 1 minus x square minus z square, y means k is a square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. So this part becomes k then. So 0 to z equal to 0 to k time being, for only for this step, dz, dy, dx. So inside k there is x and y, but this is a standard split, sine inverse of z by k, which is equal to x equal to 0 to 1 as it is, y equal to 0 to square root as it is. This becomes sine inverse of z of divided by k, z equal to 0 to k. So that makes our work simple, dy dx. Till the limits are over, we are not going to do any other work. So when I put the upper limit, minus lower limit, x as it is, y as it is, upper limit wherever z is k, k by k it becomes sine inverse of 1, minus lower limit is z equal to 0, sine inverse 0, which is 0, into dy dx as it is. So dy dx as it is. Now all of you know that sine of pi by 2 90 degrees is 1. So if I interchange this sine this side, sine inverse 1. So sine this side it becomes sine inverse 1 is pi by 2. So sine inverse 1 is pi by 2. X equal to 0 to 1. Y equal to 0 to square root. Pi by 2, and all of you know that sine inverse 0 is 0, which is dy dx. Now pi by 2 is constant. We can take pi by 2 outside and see that we can integrate with respect to y. So we'll have to integrate with respect to y because variable limits are there. So this is the variable limits. We'll have to integrate with respect to y first. So integrate with respect to y, keeping x constant. So now this is over, x equal to constant, written, waiting for you. Very good. So when I integrate that, I equal to x as it is, pi by 2 outside, only dy integration, y between 0 to square root, x as it is. So when I integrate with respect to y, once again, that becomes y dy, y become dy has become y, hence when I substitute here, yes, equal to pi by 2 as it is, 0 to 1 as it is, upper limit square root of 1 minus x square, lower limit 0. So now when I put x equal to sin theta here, dx equal to cos theta, limits will change, x is 0 to 1, if x is 0, sin theta 0, theta 0, if x is 1, sin theta 1, theta pi by 2, so limits have also changed, time being I becomes theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, square root of 1 minus sine square theta, and dx is cos theta d theta. So this also becomes cos theta, totally it is pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, cos square theta d theta. So now we will take a small pause, and many times such integrations. Suppose integration 0 to pi by 2 sin raised to 6 theta. Instead of sin, it can be cos also. Cos raised to same 6, you make it 5, then go on writing all odd numbers and start with 6, 6 fold 2. If you 1 multiply by pi by 2. Suppose if it is 0 to pi by 2 sin raised to 7 theta. 7 you make it 6, write all even numbers. Writes from 7, 7, 5, 3. If it is odd, you multiply by 1. Suppose if this is 4, then you should not write first part. 4 becomes 3, 1, 4, 2, pi by 2. That is, suppose if it is 0 to pi by 2, cos raised to 4 I will take. It is very similar to sine. No change in the value of this if you change to sine. Subtract 1 from 4, 4 becomes 3. Then write all odd. Here 4 to pi by 2. If it is 2, what happens? In a very similar fashion, 2 becomes 1. That's all. And here you write divided by 2. Yes. So 2 becomes 1 divided by 2 pi by 2. So whenever it is sine square or cos square theta, 1 by 2 pi by 2 pi by 4, don't forget. Here I am completing this pi by 2. This has become 1 by 2 pi by 2. Hence pi square by 8 will be our final answer. So that this is a special example. So we'll go to the next example. Again, variety is our concentration now. Variety is our concentration. More and more examples, more and more variety, you will start getting accustomed to this. Let us take the next example. Evaluate. We'll make it a little thicker. Suppose we are asked to find 0 to A, 0 to X, 0 to x plus y, e raised to x plus y plus z, some dx dy dz. First step is always assigning limits. I equal to, let us keep as it is first, 0 to a, 0 to x, 0 to x plus y, e raised to x plus y, z. Let us see the limits what we have to assign. First one, this has to be limit of z because this is x and y, z is not there. So this is dz. Next one, yes, if you assigned it already, well and good. Take something different. Here already z is over means this has to be limit of y because xyz already has a limit of z, remains is x and y. This cannot be, x is not for x, x is for something else, so that y is also over now. Remains is x has to be last and it has to be constant limits. So second one is y and third one, last one is x. Last one is x. Naturally, we have to integrate with respect to z. keeping X and Y constants. Quite interesting example because it is a little different from the previous one. I equal to X limits as it is, Y limits as it is, dy dx. In this, it is something like e raised to 2 plus z dz. Because this part is constant. So when you integrate e raised to 2 plus z, e raised to 2 plus z, as it is. Or you can separate out e square and e raised to z. And then if you integrate also e square, e raised to z integration is e raised to z. So e raised to 2 plus z only will get back. But this 2, in this 2 you have to substitute as x plus y. So this 2 becomes x plus y, which is a constant. So e raised to 2 plus z, instead of 2 plus z, I should have written x plus y. Okay. Done. So this becomes e raised to x plus y plus z. Between the limits z equal to 0 to z equal to x plus y dy dx as it is, dy dx as it is. Now when I substitute the limits, wherever z is there you have to substitute. Means wherever only z part is there, you substitute the limits x plus y. As it is, little bit careful here for this example, y equal to 0 to x as it is, upper limit e raised to x plus y plus this z becomes x plus y minus e raised to this x plus y as it is, this z becomes 0. So z is not remaining in the next step. Now integrate with respect to x, but this becomes e raised to 2 times x plus y. You can write it as x equal to 0 to a, y equal to 0 to x, e raised to 2x plus e raised to 2y minus e raised to x e raised to y, so that only y part in the next case you can integrate. So then definitely I'll write integrate with respect to y, I equal to x equal to 0 to a, this part as it is, integration of e raised to 2y is e raised to 2y divided by 2 minus e raised to x as it is, integration of e raised to y is e raised to y equal to 0 to x dx as it is, upper limit minus lower limit. X equal to 0 to a as it is, e raised to 2x as it is, upper limit y is x, 2x it becomes, minus lower limit, y equal to 0 means e raised to 0 is 1, divided by 2 as it is. So this is first term over, minus e raised to x, upper limit wherever y is there x, minus lower limit wherever y is there 0, e raised to 0, 1. So only dx remains, only x remains, that is correct also. So we'll simplify and make it ready for integration. So first one is half of, take this e raised to 2 inside, e raised to 4x minus e raised to 2x minus of, take this e raised to x inside, e raised to 2x minus of e raised to x. With a little difficulty, we can simplify this, because 4x term is there, which I'll write separately. Half of e raised to 4x term is there. So there are two e raised to 2x terms. One is minus half and one is minus 1. So that becomes minus 3 by 2 e raised to 2x. So minus of minus plus e raised to x. So please check it out. E raised to 4x by 2 minus 3 by 2 e raised to 2x plus e raised to x, which is very simple. Make ready for integration. And this is ordinary integration. Many times you have done such integrations. So last part, when I integrate it, this becomes equal to half of e raised to 4x by 4 minus 3 by 2 into e raised to 2x upon 2 plus e raised to x as it is, x equal to 0 to 1. Here x equal to 0 will not make it 0, that is important point. In the last cases we are polynomials, that's why it was becoming 0. So x equal to 0 is not making them 0, please note. So both upper and lower limits are non-zero. So throughout, when I put upper limit, first one, 1 by 8, x equal to 1, x equal to 1, x equal to 1, e raised to 4 by 2 by 3 times divided by 4 plus e raised to 1 upper limit over minus the lower limit, x equal to 0, x equal to 0, x equal to 0, all exponential is becoming 1. Simply 1 by 8 minus 3 by 2, sorry. Plus 1. So that this simplification is not difficult. Finally, I will write the answer, e raised to 4 by 8 minus 3 by 4 times e square plus e. And this simplification, if you do it, not difficult at all, minus 3 by 8, you will get this the answer. So again, the same slogan, more number of examples, more variety. So you will get idea of what you are doing. Get used to it. See, it is better if you repeat these examples without looking to them also. Again, evaluate. We shall change only x, y, z, we should not get used to. We shall change some variables now. Suppose 0 to pi by 2 is there, constant. Next one is 0 to a sin theta is there. Suppose next one, 0 to square root of, not square root, but 0 to a square minus r square whole divided by a. So r theta, and one more variable is there. I'll give you. So these are all the variables, dr, d theta, dz. So here, in terms of r, theta, z, something you can write, but you are given only you to integrate r. Important one, here it is very, very important. Here it is very, very important. Because this is a special case of assigning limits. Let us assign one by one. I equal to 0 to a sin theta. It should come to your mind that this cannot be for theta. And 0 to a square minus out of r theta z, this cannot be for r. This cannot be for theta also, because if theta is over, again you have to integrate with respect to theta. Once again, this cannot be for r. If I write theta here, theta integration will be over, then again you cannot integrate theta terms. This cannot be for theta also. This has to be for z equal to. So this is little tricky. Now z is over, theta cannot be for theta, it has to be for r. R is over, only left is theta. This example, please practice. First with respect to z, then with respect to r, or last one with respect to theta, you have to do it. So now I'll write integrate with respect to z, keeping r constant. So when I write it, I equal to theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, r equal to 0 to a sine theta, r as it is, dr d theta as it is, dz integration is z, 0 to square root of, not square root of, a square minus r square divided by a. So now again, upper limit minus lower limit, theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, r equal to 0 to some sine theta. Upper limit is wherever z is there, just substitute here, a square minus r as it is, a square minus r square divided by a. Lower limit 0, so divided by nothing is there by mystic error root, dr d theta. With little simplification, this integration is ready for integrating with respect to r also. So now you integrate with respect to r. Integrate with respect to r, theta as constant for time being, I becomes now, but before integrating, theta equal to 0 to pi by 2, this a can be kept outside, r into a, so this is, suppose I write in the next step, a square r minus r into r square r cube, so I am integrating with respect to r, theta not touched. So that becomes equal to 1 by a as it is, 0 to pi by 2 as it is, which is for theta. R dr is r square by 2, a square r square by 2 minus r cube becomes r raised to 4 by 4. Limits are well known, which is a sine theta. Okay, so here limits still r equal to 0 to a sine theta, I have to write. Which becomes 1 by a as it is, upper limit, wherever r is there, a sine theta, a square sine square theta, minus a raised to 4, sine raised to 4 theta, d theta. Now, first one, 1 by a as it is. A raised to 4, 0 to pi by 2 sin square is 1 by 2 pi by 2, already one more 1 by 2 is there, this 1 by 2 is there, minus a raised to 4 by 4, sin raised to 4 becomes 3 1 by 4 2 pi by 2. So one of the a's will get cancelled. We can simplify by taking pi by 2 also outside. So finally, if you simplify a bit, that part I can take liberty. Naturally, a cube term is remaining, one pi is coming out. So that 5 by 64, you should verify. 5 by 64, you should verify. So again, today we covered many of the examples. In the next cases, I would like to see that you are not given the limits, but you are given the region, for example. For example, let us keep the curiosity for the next class and say bye today. Suppose you are asked to integrate. Example, next time what I am doing is, integrate over the region R, some xy, dx, dy, where R is the region bounded by, parabola y square equal to x, line y equal to x. So you are not given the limits. That time you'll have to draw this y square equal to x. You have to draw this y equal to x and mark these parts. This becomes our region of integration. And we have to see that lowest part of y, when I vary parallel to y-axis, this elementary area, if I vary like this, I vary. Y is varying from straight line to y is varying from parabola. So that becomes y limits x to square root of x. This I am just keeping curiosity. This strip you vary from minimum to this point becomes 1, 1, need not verify because it is satisfying 1, 1 also, 1, 1 also here. So this is from x, y axis to this line. So y axis is x equal to 0 and this line is x equal to 1. So that becomes x equal to 0, 1. More details we shall see in the next class. So in the next class, you have given the region and we have to draw the figure and put the limits. That is the next variety. Till that, thank you so much. Bye.